So I'm Dr. Adam Reynolds. I'm a glaucoma specialist here in the United States, and I'm actually serve on a couple patient care committee forums for the American Glaucoma Society, and I have for about 20, 30 years. And these issues about these cosmetic iris implants has been something that we've been following quite closely and making policy about for several years. It became very obvious about 10 years ago that the risk of complications with these artificial iris implants was so high, upwards of 25 to 30%, and usually the main problem is glaucoma, that the FDA stopped any clinical trials of these in the United States and actually recommended to the Food and Health Administration, to the FDA, that these could not even be put in under an IDE in the United States. There are many non-approved, FDA-approved surgical devices that are being studied, or maybe will never be studied, that get a pass from the FDA, where doctors can use these in the United States for compassionate use, and some of these are cosmetic things. It was deemed by the American Glaucoma Society and the American Academy of Ophthalmology that these iris implants were so dangerous that they actually made it illegal to actually implant these in the United States, whether it was cosmetic, patients were paying cash, and an IDE, or what's called an investigational device exception, was unacceptable for these. So currently, these are like just a big no-no anathema to eye doctors in the United States. And we have tried to reach out to governments, agencies in other countries, especially where these are popular, especially down in Latin and South America, to pleading with their governments to make these the same status, to make them completely illegal, because they are so dangerous and cause so many problems. So that being said, you know, that just kind of covers all the bases here. Yeah. These things are so bad that don't let any doctor try to talk you into them. And any doctor that tries to talk a patient into having this procedure done actually is not only unethical, they are immoral. All they want is your money. They want your money, and they are not thinking about your safety. They're kind of taking advantage of this whole idea that patients with brown eyes want lighter colored eyes, and you know, I'm not going to talk about that. That just is what it is. But do not get talked into this method. Use cosmetic contact lenses over the surface. They look great. I know a lot of people who use them, but do not get these implants into the inside of the eye. That not only are they very costly, they're extremely dangerous. And so that's all I got to say about that. Thanks
okay.
for listening.
Thank you, doctor. Okay. Just one last question. Can you tell really fast about my situation?
Well, what I
eyes?
Got with this situation, with this patient's eyes, is that the fit was so bad with these in the eye that it has caused glaucoma, and it has caused a permanent distortion of the pupil. The pupils are large. Even though the lens is clear and we don't have a cataract, we got now a situation now where no matter what we do, there's photophobia, light sensitivity, and also distortions of the vision because the pupil can't get that down small enough so the patient can read without reading glasses. So these are permanent changes, and to fix them is extremely difficult. These changes cannot be reversed because the part of the pupil has died. It's actually kind of shriveled up and died.
Oh my God.
And so that's the problem. That's why these eyes look like
God.
They do. And that's what these implants do. They cause ischemia of the iris, and they kind of kill part of it. And that's why it distorts the pupil like this, and also part of the reason why they cause glaucoma. So that's what the situation is with you, and why you have all these problems that you got.
Well,
even though
mm-hmm.
we've taken them out, the taking them out doesn't solve the problem. The problems that they've caused are still there. We can't, and now we're fighting with what are we going to do to try to fix it? Yeah.
Well, Dr. Reynolds, thank you so much.
You're very
welcome. And guys, listen to the doctor and to me.
Please,
this
please
is Patty.
Do not,
please,
don't
please,
do it.
Don't do it. This is Patty. I had an emergency today.
Okay.
Oh my God, I get blind in my right eye because I couldn't see. So I came here to the emergency with Dr. Reynolds. My eye pressure was again 57. He had to poke my eye, like make a hole in my right eye so he can release the pressure, because I couldn't see anything. And I